Clark County are also monitoring the rising river where the town of Utica is getting hit hard. Kristen Drew is live in Utica with the latest on the efforts to protect the community from flooding. Kristen.
Vicki, here in Utica, water has already started flooding homes along the river, but workers are now putting sand across streets to keep the water back and to keep it from flooding other areas.
The water, actually, it's about 50, 75 feet out, and there's docks and stuff down there.
Glenn Murphy lives on the Ohio River, but jokes that he sometimes lives in the river. He built this home after the 1997 flood.
When in 97, I'd seen where the water was, looked at the history, brought it up high enough where we could use it, easily get the car and stuff up in here, but not so high to where you would have to use elevators and all that.
Murphy is now preparing his home for high water, but not expecting any major damage. This home is floodproof.
This is all styrofoam and concrete, and this is waterproof stucco, just like you see the outside of a building, a commercial building, and it's all, there's all sealed, and you just clean it and go right back out.
It's tough. It really is.
Perry Smith and his family spent Monday morning moving household items from his mother's home. She passed away on Sunday, and now Smith is also preparing for flooding.
We've done this once before in 1997, and it got up to the door handle at the base of the windows at that time. But I'm not gambling with Mother Nature.
At Town Hall, Clark County officials have put out sandbags for residents to protect their homes.
Got a couple little areas. I may use them. I'm not sure. You know, it may get in and it may not. I'm still a waiting game. I still have 2 feet left before it gets in my garage level.
Lester Wood drove home to Utica from Florida to prepare for high water.
It's a guessing game, so we just drove straight through Friday night and got in there Saturday morning. It's like a 17-hour drive.
As the storm nears, Lester Wood fears he may spend the night with no power or electricity. He plans to use a gas lantern.
On the river, why not?
And as for any security concerns out here, police are patrolling this area to make sure that any homes left abandoned will not be vandalized. Live in Utica, I'm Kristen Drew, WLKY News.
Thank you.